Alright, so in this tutorial, it's just going to be a quick, simple tutorial on how you can put a pattern on a shape, as well as how you can save a pattern into your library so you can use it for future projects. So it's quite simple here in Shortcut Slot 3. You just have to have that shape selected, and with that shape selected, you can go down here to the fill, and you can go ahead and select that drop-down, and you have three options: none, color, and pattern. We're going to fill this with a pattern. Now, if you have not selected pattern before on that shape, a new window should appear. And you'll see down here, you'll have a couple folders here. So you have three folders. And right now, mine's basic standard. Nothing has been previously saved. Now, if you're just going to load an image for one-time use kind of thing, you'll go over here to this tab up here, which is Load Images. And you can go ahead and hit the Load Image button, find your image, and you can load it for single-time use. Now, if you want to use it for multiple items, you know, of course you can select the folder that you want. You can even create a new folder here. You know, you can call it My Favorite Patterns, or you can call it my Floral and hit OK. And once you do that, a little folder should appear down here, and you can go ahead and select that, and in there you can either create another subfolder, or you can create you can go ahead and add an image. So you can select that button there, and as you can see, I'm going to go ahead and select this seamless pattern right here and hit open. And automatically it appears over here in the preview window. You can select that and you can hit preview and actually apply it to your mat. Over here you can choose your size adjustments, you know, so say you wanted this to be, maybe a 5 inch by 5 inch, and see, just see what it does. And you can hit preview and you can see how it changes the pattern drastically. Once you have your pattern set the way you would like, all you have to do is hit the OK button, and it's good to go. Now, if you want to change it, all you have to do is select this little square here that has your pattern in it, and you can change it to something else. You know, so you can go to Scout Library, and you can change it to, maybe you want to cheetah print, and you can hit preview and see how that turns out. You know, and if you're looking for seamless patterns, I would just suggest go ahead and do a Google search, do seamless patterns, click on the images and see what comes up. There's lots of sites out there that will either A, cost money, or B, allow you to use them for free. So with that, I'm Rob with ScrappyDude.com, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.